So the type of hosting provider you actually choose mostly determine your success or failure of your website. So in today's video, I'll be reviewing this particular hosting platform called EasyWp by Namecheap. So being a user for a past 3 or 4 years now, so I'll be doing a quick review about the pros and the cons, what you have to know before buying this particular hosting platform, and is it worth your money. So ensure to watch this from beginning to end so that you don't end up wasting your money. So without wasting much of your time, let me quickly tell you everything you need to know about this EasyWp hosting platform, like from Namecheap. So this particular hosting platform has just been integrated to this particular hosting provider Namecheap, because most times the popular hosting plan that is available for WordPress owner is actually the Stellar Plus, which is around $1.98 per month, and this one is around $2.98 per month. But recently, you know, they are trying to integrate a WordPress dedicated hosting, which is EasyWp. So this particular hosting platform, they are much okay, like for a business owner that want to start up a particular website that doesn't want a shared hosting, because this one is more like VPS, mini VPS hosting. So when they started this particular hosting platform, I actually get their EasyWp starter plan. So on this particular EasyWp starter plan, which is around the $34.86 every single year, so I actually get 10 gigabytes, like 10 gig SSD storage, and I can actually receive up to 20k visitors every month. And one good thing about this particular EasyWp hosting is because I'm going to get a dedicated IP, so I'm not sharing a hosting with another user on the platform. So but if you are a business owner that have huge amount of traffic, have a lot of plugin to install on your website, it's more important, like it's more advisable to actually go for this particular package, which is called EasyWp Turbo plan. So with this particular Turbo plan, you are going to get 50 gig SSD storage. You can actually receive up to 20k visitor every single month, and they have 1L CPU and 1S of RAM, like likewise free SSL certificates. So one of the disadvantage, like the red flag about this particular starter plan, is because I can't really get CDN and I can't get free SSL certificate, so it actually affects my website a lot. I'm going to be showing you my dashboard, what you have to know about this particular hosting platform. And lastly, the last plan, which is called EasyWp Supersonnet. So this is one of the best for a well-established organization. They have on this particular plan, you can get up to 10 gigabytes and also 500 visitors per month. You know, this one is quite relative, it can be more and it can be less. So and they have 2S of CPU, RAM, and up to 9.99 uptime. So and also free CDN and free SSL 70k. So actually most of this claim might be true, but I'll actually show you what is the outcome based on this particular experiment I've done with this particular hosting. So as you can see, this is my dashboard, this website I'm currently hosting on this particular EasyWp. So one of the disadvantage about this particular hosting platform EasyWp is the fact that you are not going to be given a cPanel. You know, all shared hosting actually have cPanel. If I'm using one of the shared hosting on Namecheap or any other platform, definitely you will be given this cPanel. So this cPanel allow you to do a lot of customization. Honestly, you are going to do a lot. You can actually install WordPress on your website, you can actually install script on your website, like if you have PHP scripts, like all these two websites should be able to install it on your website. So but using EasyWp, you are only limited only WordPress. It is going to be installed automatically for you. You know, if you are a beginner, it's more advisable, but you later end up knowing that it's not really good, because there are a lot of the problem with not using cPanel. So one of it is actually, like, let me go back to see how my website is performing. So as you can see now, actually tested this website using Google speed test to actually see how it performs. As you can see, this website actually perform woefully, like 7 out of 100, and if you check on mobile, this is actually 79. And I'm using other shared hosting on Namecheap, and they perform up actually right, like up to 90 and 100. So because I actually optimize the website to actually read this minimum of 100 or 70 or 18 and above. So and I've tried all my possible best to actually try to hire someone on Fiverr to be able to do the work for me, but this is the one of the disadvantage of using EasyWp, honestly, because they can't really work on the cPanel, because it doesn't have cPanel. So let's go back to my website. So as you can see, they don't have cPanel. So if I should click on this manage information. So this is the cPanel. So there's nothing much, just giving you the information about the website, like how many usage, like out of 10 gig I've used 5 gig already. So and the, like with this particular hosting platform, I don't have access to SSS certificate. You know, I'm using a starter plan. So although if I'm using the other plan, which is Stonic or other plan, I can be able to get it. So another thing I don't like about this particular EasyWp hosting platform is the fact that if you want to like migrate your website from another hosting to another, it's going to be a great difficult, because as you can see, like this particular hosting platform, the package I'm using, which is starter plan, I contact their support to actually see if I can be able to migrate my website from this EasyWp to their normal shared hosting. The response I actually got is the fact that this website, they are not backing up. I have to back it up for myself, and it's not possible for me to actually migrate it from another hosting unless I use other plugin like all-in-one WP migration. So, and more importantly, this my website actually reach 1 gig, and you know, if you are using only one WP migration, the file you can actually migrate is around 500 megabytes. So I have to pay at least around $70 to $80 to be able to buy the plugin to be able to migrate my website. So if you want to use EasyWp, you have to think about it very, very well. You have to think about it, because if you are using shared hosting, like all these shared hosting, if you want to migrate your website at any time, or if you want to migrate from Namecheap to another shared hosting, they will definitely, Namecheap is going to definitely help you out, because it's WordPress to WordPress, it doesn't have any issue. So another thing I actually like about this particular EasyWp is the fact that you'll be given a dedicated IP address, and this IP address doesn't allow you to be able to secure your website. You are not sharing your hosting platform with another users, and more importantly, the security is quite much okay, because if you are using shared hosting, like all these shared hosting, there is high chances that your website might have a little problem. Like probably if other user on your shared plan is actually using your website to do maybe black hat or the rest, so you might actually have that in time, like a problem. So the last thing I actually eat about this particular EasyWp hosting is the fact that, okay, let's go back to our dashboard. So this is my hosting. Let's go back to my dashboard on WordPress. So to be able to actually see the reason why it's really much difficult for me to actually recommend this particular hosting platform, I will actually recommend shared hosting ahead of this particular EasyWp hosting. So if you like this content so far, we'd like you to subscribe to my YouTube channel, and also hit the like button now. At least YouTube can be able to share this video to a lot of people that actually need this particular review. So if you go back to my dashboard, so this is my dashboard, and we will go to plugin. Let's click on plugin to see what plugin they are using to actually make it EasyWp. From my own opinion, though, so like if you check this particular hosting platform, we have a lot of plugins that I'm installed. There's one that I'm installed myself, and there is one that is must use. So if you click on this must use, we should be able to see what is actually happening here. So as you can see, they actually have inbuilt plugin which is called EasyWp. To me, I feel probably they are using this plugin to actually make it EasyWp. I don't know, but I just feel like I prefer shared hosting ahead of this EasyWp hosting. So, and if you check, let's check another plugin, which is a drop-in. So this is the two plugin that is going to come automatically with this particular EasyWp hosting. So it is called advancedcache.php. I think this one is concerning about like the site speed and object cache php. So these three plugin and inbuilt plugin, so it's going to come with it. You can't delete this plugin, you can't be able to do anything on it. So lastly, if you go back to plugin, let's try to add plugin right now. So let's try to add plugin. You know, if you have your website, you want to do the optimization very well to really make it more to speed very well. So if you type in any catch, let's type in a particular keyword which is called catch. So you know, you can actually use catch plugin to be able to catch your website to so that you'll be serving the recent version. So one of the disadvantages I don't really like about this particular hosting platform EasyWp is the fact that you can't actually add any catch plugin on it, because they have inbuilt catch plugin. So for example, W3 total catch is not allowed to be added on the server. So and WP super catch is not allowed, and more so that this particular cache, which is reader. So there are a lot of disadvantage. There are a lot. For example, now if I want to optimize this website, I might not want to use their inbuilt caching plugin. I want to use other caching plugin like EasyWp Rocket and the rest. But I can't really use it because the fact that it's not allowed to be able to use other plugin except for the one they actually give us. So this is one of the disadvantages. This is one of the things I don't really like about this particular hosting platform. So because there are a lot of limitations. Like, this is my recommendation based on choosing an hosting platform. So if you know that you are just starting up, you don't really know much about hosting, you don't really know more about it, you can actually go for this EasyWp. So because they have everything is going to be done for you, you don't need anything, you don't need to do anything. The website setup is going to be done for you automatically. But you have to consider the fact that if you want to migrate under hosting, you have to pay a lot of money. So that's one of the reasons why you should think about it very well. So on a normal ground, you should start with a shared hosting. So Namecheap is quite good. Like, I've been using this shared hosting on almost all of my websites. So you can actually start with their shared hosting. You are very sure that even if you have a website that is not very fast, you can do it yourself. Install some plugin so it will speed up your website, or hire someone on Fiverr to do it for you. It's not something that is very hard. So I hope you find great value in this content. So if you want to know how to migrate your website from one hosting to another, I'm going to drop this particular video. You should watch it next. Thanks for watching. I will see you in my next video. Bye.